It's gonna be fine. You can do anything. Go you! Woohoo! Hey everybody!
Hey everybody.
Stanley is gonna build some cool stuff today. Okay, here's this kitchen so far. Don't look at the mess. We're not quite done right here yet. I gotta do the wainscot in here. Whoops, hang on.
Hey everybody!
Okay, I'm putting the breakfast nook here. I'll take care of this in a little bit. And then the kitchen is going in. It's gonna be over here like this, right? So, breakfast nook, kitchen. But this wall was a little bit empty. So we wanted to do a coffee bar. But, okay, here's the thing. The breakfast nook that goes here, I got a bench from Amazon, of course. It sticks out 24, 25 inches, so it's pretty. Ooh, I about fell. I'm about to sneeze. It sticks out 24, 25 inches, right? And I didn't want 24-inch base cabinets here because we'd be right back all squishy and squeezed up like it was when we got this place. You remember, it was a mess. So, what we're gonna do is the little trick where you use uppers for downers. That don't sound good. Upper cabinets as lower cabinets. And we're gonna show you guys what to do, how to do it. And don't worry about this crunchy wall. I had to peel some wallpaper. I still have a little bit of paper to pull and paint and everything. This is gonna be tiled for the backsplash, so it all gets covered up anyway. It's gonna be okay.
Yep,
and we gotta refinish this trim. Handy Stanley got this window shortened. Remember, it was long. We had to shorten it so the cabinets could go under it. But we gotta go pick up the tile. And
it'll be ugly before it's pretty.
That's right. It always gets worse before it gets better. Just hang in there. It's gonna be okay. And the coffee bar will have the same tile. And then it'll go up between. I'm doing 6 feet of cabinets here, and then I'm going to do an 18 and an 18 up here, and do a couple of shelves here with the under cabinet lights. So, should be cute. See what we can do with this today. Okay, the coffee bar is going to be centered on this little wall right here, and I got 2 36-inch upper cabinets to use. See how they're only a foot? They're only a foot deep. They're not 2 feet deep like that. So, we were 105, so 52 and a half is center. Get a center line, level up a center line all the way. So the deal is, these cabinets are 36 wide, which is what I wanted, but they're only 30 inches tall, and I couldn't get the 36 inches tall because we need a toe kick. This is a toe kick, so when you're like standing in front of the cabinet, your feet can go up under there, then it's like not weird, see? It's pretty important. So if we had bought 36 inch cabinets, that would have been the right height, but there wouldn't have been a toe kick, it would have been weird. So we're gonna put the 30 inch cabinets. These, the normal ones, are 34 and a half without the countertop. So we need to match that. So we're gonna build a platform under them, pushed back 3.5 inches.
Yep, 3.5.
This is 3.5 inches. So the platform will come out minus 3.5 inches for the toe kick, 4.5 inches tall to give us a total of 34.5 inches. Got it?
Got it.
Okay. Okay, so what is happening is these are 12 inches. And I'm gonna do a couple uppers up here, and they're 12 inches, but I didn't want the lowers to be exactly the same depth as the uppers because I thought that would be a little bit weird. So I'm gonna pull these out 1.5 inches, and then with the countertop overhang, that this the bottom will be out 2 inches more than the top. Is this making sense? Okay, apparently I talk with my hands. So, we are going to build the platform. We'll go back to the wall to here, minus the 3.5 inches. And where this is gonna have a space, we're gonna want to put a side back on this that goes all the way to the wall to hide this. You don't want a hole. So build your platform to this, not to this. It's a quarter inch difference. So when we put the side on, that'll cover completely the platform and everything. Is that making sense?
Yes.
Okay.
Very much so.
I'll show you that more in a minute when he gets it built. So our total length face to face is 6 feet minus a quarter on this side and a quarter on the other side. So the platform will be 71 and a half inches long total, the platform. 71 and a half, not 72. So you should have something that looks like this, centered on your wall.
Now you gotta level it.
And we know the floor ain't gonna be level. Don't get your hopes up.
Oh, that's a pretty good house.
All right. Pretty good?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Attach your platform to the floor. Attach it back there to the studs.
Very attached.
Attach it everywhere. Since I wanted the bottom cabinets to come out an inch and a half further than the top, we're just going to put a 2x4 on the wall at the top and the bottom to bring it out an inch and a half. And then we can attach straight to that. So attach your 2x4 if you're doing it this way. Attach your 2x4 to the studs, and then you can attach the cabinet to the 2x4s. Okay, platform is down. Two 2x4s are on the wall. Now we just got to set these up there, anchor them to the 2x4s. So here's what we're looking like on the side. We got our toe kicked. We're toe kicking.
Kicking toe.
Kicking toes. And we will put a new side on this that'll cover up all that. And I'll paint it white. And it'll be all good in Evelyn's neighborhood. You gotta level it. Y'all will remember. I'm having flashbacks.
I'm not kicking out in the middle. It's one solid piece. So,
oh. Really? Puppy break. Okay, we got two of them mounted. That looks so good. Hey, when y'all see me from this angle down here, that does not mean... That don't mean that I'm old and I'm sitting on the floor. I'm just trying to get y'all a good straight ahead shot of what we're doing. Totally not sitting on the floor, taking a break. Measuring for the countertop. You want to come out past this and cover the door. So we're going to go 14 and a half deep. And I'm going to come past each end a quarter, so we are 72 and a half long. 72 and a half by 14 and a half. Oh my goodness, look at it. Ain't that purdy? That's so purdy, ain't that purdy? Okay, this is 6 feet, and I got 2 18-inch cabinets, one for each side, so that's 3 feet, and then we'll have 2 3-foot shelves between them. And look at this guy. He looks like he's right out of the Sarah McLachlan commercials. Poor fella. Rocky, you good, buddy? Okay, so we got the... Dang, my finger. Okay, we got the countertop on. Still got to seal it, and that's going to darken it up a little bit. But look how good it goes with the floor. I love it. So like I was saying, these countertops come 24 inches deep. So when I ripped it down, I only needed 14 and a half here. And that left us with 10 and 3/8 of the cutoff. And that's it was an 8-foot long countertop. So I only have 3 feet here and 3 feet here. So I'm going to use 6 feet of the 8 feet that was left over from the countertop for my shelves. And the bottom one will be there. And then that one will be there. And this is a bigger space up here. I know it's weird. It's going to drive me crazy. Because I gave it room for a TV, I'm going to mount on my TV up there. Because I didn't like that I couldn't knock this wall out between the living room and the kitchen. So, because that's where the basement steps are behind this wall. So, since I couldn't knock the wall out and I couldn't open it up, I wanted to at least give them a TV. If they want to hang out here at their breakfast nook, have some coffee, watch the Today Show, you know. Okay, what's happening here is, I don't know. Wife made it all complicated, like I do. And I wanted it lit up, as I usually do, because I like under cabinet lights. And I wanted the shelves to have them too. So what it is this is solid. So Handy Stanley is going to use the router and figure out the thickness of the under cabinet light and router out a circle. Router out a pocket for the light to go in so it's not just sitting right on the bottom of the shelf. Because that one's up really high and you're going to see under it. And I want them like tucked up in there. So now he gets to figure that out. It's going to be fine. He can do anything. Go you! Woohoo! And this is where I made a boo-boo. Sorry about the skinny shot right here, guys. I thought I had them. I can't find them on my phone anywhere. The sideways shots of Sunny doing the tile. So we have skinny videos of it, but it's okay. I was a little bit scared of this tile at first because it's so bold, but it totally grew on me. I love it now. I think it fits the Evelyn retro vibe so good, and it's bright and happy, and I love it. The last thing the coffee bar needed was new hardware. We got these handles from Amazon. I'll put the link in the description. And a quick flashback to before shots of this area. Pretty gross, pretty buggy, pretty bad. And after, oh my goodness. So much better, so much happier, so much brighter, so much cleaner. Let me know what you guys think about this tile and this coffee bar idea. You guys remember to be good and do good. Thank you for watching. We'll see you next time. Love you. Bye.